Well, so to understand Kubernetes, first you have to understand why everyone got so excited about Docker and containers. And the key insight there is that Docker and the technologies that Docker built upon allowed people to take a program that they wanted to run on a serving computer, a server, package that up in a way that it can run on your laptop, it could run in a test environment, or it could run in your production environment with very few changes and with a high degree of predictability. Once you have that building block of being able to run a particular program in a reliable way on a computer, the next level up, and this is where orchestration in Kubernetes comes in, is figuring out and automating which computer do I want to run this program on. So it's not just running a container on this particular computer, it's about find the right computer to run this container on. Once you have that primitive, then you can start scaling these things out. So instead of running one instance of a container, you can easily run 10 or 100 instances of a container. Along the way, as we built all this automation, you start seeing really big benefits around workflow. So now we can not only have a more efficient and automated way to deploy this stuff, but that actually changes the way people start thinking about deploying, building, and operating software.